Can I do something for you, Mr. Bond?
Just a drink. A martini, shaken, not...
Hello, children. I bring you love.
It's a monster! Kill it! Kill it!
It's not a monster. It's Mr. Burns.
Oh, it's Mr. Burns.
Kill it! Kill it!
Oh. Welcome to Shaken Not Nerd, episode 17, Aliens Week.
Woo! I love my alien stuff, which apparently every alien is a woo girl.
Every alien is a woo, yeah, woo!
Woo, let's get fucked up!
He just wanted to borrow a cup of sugar!
I ate so many chests last night.
I'm your host, or semi-host, or co-pilot, I don't know.
Co-pilot.
Yeah, Dudi Dutrum. And with me, as always, is the face-hugger to my egg, the shoulder cannon to my predator, the no wallet to my Zoidberg.
The rape to my species.
Yeah, right. I can do that. That is Ian, the huge, the footlong, the Johnson.
Oh, thank you. What an intro. I want to thank Mum. Without her, I wouldn't be here today. And that's about it. All right, fuck you all.
I'd like to thank my mum. She is a queen. Ian, so most important question of the day is, what are you doing?
What are you doing?
What are you doing?
No, what are you doing?
What are you doing?
No, what are you doing?
What are you doing?
So, Mr. Johnson, what are you doing?
What am I doing?
Yeah.
I'm hungover as fuck. Not as fuck. I'm a little bit hangover. A little bit hangover.
Hangover?
Hangover. Mm. Not part two or three, the good one.
Now, why are you hangover?
Why am I hangover? Because we had a few drinks last night.
Drinks.
Drax. What did we do? We had a Christmas catch up
with our mates.
So we did a little KK.
Yeah.
Only two K's.
Yeah, we had Christmas swapping presents and everyone was fighting for the bottle of Pimm's.
Yeah. Instead of punch we had Pimm's.
We got pretty what was
Pim Pim Mini Pim Mini Pim Pim Shoto.
That's it. He was walking around dead movies with a bottle of Pimm's going, Pim Pimity, Pim Pimity.
Yes. I'll get fucked up if you will too.
And, yeah, we watched a movie in preparation for today.
Oh, I'm ready!
Oh, he's trying!
How's work? How's things on your end on work?
Oh, it's so lonely without you, Dutrum. Is that what you want me to say?
Yeah.
We all miss you, sir. No, we don't give a fuck. Bye-bye! See ya!
Bye-bye!
I like how I was doing that, like, as I was walking out the door, I was just yelling, like, in a call center, going, Bye-bye-bye!
Everyone on their phones going, shut up!
Yeah, all the new people going, who's that guy?
Who is he leaving?
Yeah, my work's going well. It's quite fun. It's, yeah. I shaved my head.
Yeah. In preparation for Alien Week.
Yeah.
Maybe I should put that picture up again.
Yeah.
Because Dutrum's head is elongated, is the right term to use, I think. Like an alien skull. So,
it's
fitting for this week's theme,
Alien.
We're
putting beer on my head to see if it sits there, and it did.
It's flat on top.
Maybe if someone hits me in the head hard enough, he'll, like, you know, like when you pop a bottle and you hit it somewhere and it pops back into place.
Maybe. It's like someone took a picture of a skull and just kind of accidentally stretched it out a little bit.
Oh no, I used the ruler too long here. I can't be fucking fixing it.
Classic God. Oh, a pinch too much of cunt. Oh well.
Your hair looks awful. I'd rather be bald than have your hair.
Wow. That's just rude. That's so mean, 90s Goldberg. Without the coolness or the muscle. So don't let it go to your hair.
Go to what hair? Alright, well then with that, shall we get on to this week's news and current events?
Lots of news this week, so let's jump in.
Channel 4 News, with 5-time Emmy Award winning anchor, Ron Burgundy.
Tit for tat time, motherfucker, tit for tat time.
Titties for tatties.
Now, who goes first?
You can go first. I think you got more than me.
Cool. It was shown this week, the first photo of Elizabeth Banks as Rita Repulsa for the Power Rangers film. Did you see that photo?
No.
No. Okay.
Good?
Yeah, actually, it looks pretty cool. Like, I was expecting the villain for a Power Rangers movie to be very camp, sort of like the TV show.
Mm.
And it's not.
Well, that's good, because that's what I was worried about. With the teaser trailers that we've seen so far, it has looked a little bit camp.
Yes.
For lack of a better word. Shit. It's probably a better word.
It looks pretty good. Like, it could... Like, I was expecting a lot worse, or Michael Bay Transformer worse, but it's not.
Yeah. Look, let's just hope that they don't go too ridiculous with the giant robot. And, or if they do, they deliberately go too ridiculous, which could also be good. It's just that in-between when you're trying not to be ridiculous and you're accidentally ridiculous and then you've got too much ridiculous and it's ridiculousness.
Shut the fuck up. Yeah, that's my first piece of news. So she looks pretty cool. Doesn't really look like, it looks like Elizabeth Banks, but it doesn't look like Elizabeth Banks at the same time. So it's kind of cool.
Interesting that Elizabeth Banks is in it. Like, she's a good actress. I don't think we've got any other big names.
Bryan Cranston's in it.
Oh, is he?
He's Zorbon or fucking... It's the big head in the tube that tells him what to do.
Oh, like the team leader.
The team leader of Power Rangers.
Grab that call! Nobody's going to get that.
No, it is the five people at work are going to go, what's your next piece of news?
All right. My next piece of news. There's a lot of news this week, but the Mummy teaser trailer has been released.
Yes.
Very teasing. Not so much trailer, because I think the trailer's coming out tomorrow? Monday? So,
Monday.
Or it might be Monday American time, so it might be
Tuesday
here.
Yeah.
So, either way, it doesn't show a lot. Shows a glimpse of the mummy, obviously, with her crazy-looking eye things going on.
Yeah, her iris is splitting into two.
Yeah, a lot of Tom Cruise running, which any movie with Tom Cruise in it has to have Tom Cruise running with his spear hands. Have you never noticed that? Every time he runs, he goes flat hands, spear hands.
Does he?
Yeah.
Okay.
Trademark running style.
I thought that was just Keanu Reeves.
No, it's him. He's cray-cray for Shay-Shay. And what else did we see? We also saw like a half a second, if that, glimpse of...
Russell Crowe?
Yeah, Rusty.
Rusty. Robitussin. Robitussin.
Innomina Piperdick.
Yeah, it was a pretty cool teaser. I'm looking forward to seeing the full trailer. A friend of ours was saying he's really excited for the Mummy movie. You're going to sneeze again.
No.
He's really excited for the Mummy movie, but then it was like, oh yeah, it's got Tom Cruise. Like, I'm not watching it.
Really?
Yeah.
You put him off that much.
Yeah.
But I don't think it can be that bad. Like,
don't mind Tom Cruise.
He's not bad. He's not great, but he's, you know.
I think he's good.
He holds his own in any movie he's in. Like, you never walk out. Like, you always expect him to be shit, and then you watch him and he's not corny.
Do you think people don't like him because he's a Scientologist? Like, that's why people don't like John Travolta anymore?
Probably. No, but John Travolta's also not good.
Oh, man, Wild Hogs.
Wild Hogs, wow.
Yeah, I can't think of a shit movie that he's been in recently now.
Because he hasn't been in movies recently.
Hairspray.
Oh, yep.
Moving right along. we have the Marvel vs. Capcom 4, or Infinite, I believe it's called, trailer that was dropped this morning.
Yes.
So, I've played the previous Marvel vs. Capcom 2 and 3 games, and they're really good fun. Very arcadey.
Yeah, very arcadey. This one doesn't look... Well, it's very hard to tell.
Because it's a proper trailer, it's not a gameplay trailer. Yeah.
But seems like it's going to be better quality, which, you know, maybe a little bit expect, considering how much Marvel... You know, how much movie they make, how much money their movies are making. English motherfucker, can I speak it?
Apparently not.
So hopefully, it looks like we might also get a bit more kind of cinematic Marvel in this. It looks
the Iron Man costume looks very Robert Downey Jr. cinematic.
Yeah,
except for the triangle in his head, that's about it.
Yeah, but the other games they were very comic book as opposed to movie.
Yeah.
So
maybe the Marvel Studios is going like, yeah, cool, let's make another game, but push our cinematic universe look to it.
Yeah, unless they have different costumes, because a lot of the time they do that, so they might have the general kind of cinematic one and then also have comic book ones as different costumes. That could be cool.
Yeah. Well, the one thing I've read is that there's a rumor that there's got to be no X-Men characters in it, because previously with all the other games you've had Magneto, Wolverine, Cyclops... and Marvel are starting to actually kill off the X-Men characters in their books because they don't own the rights to their movies.
Oh, wow.
So they essentially want to kill off the X-Men in their books.
That's...
So they've already done that with the Fantastic Four. There's no more Fantastic Four books.
That's interesting.
So, rumor is apparently they're killing off their X-Men characters. So Fox has just got the X-Men movies. There's no X-Men comic books because the characters are dead.
That's kind of
shit from Marvel.
Yeah, that seems kind of petty. Like,
we can't have our rights back. Fine, we'll just kill the characters off in our comics.
Yeah, it seems like they're just going to deliberately do that so that, I don't know, the movies don't do well, or they have nothing to base the movies on, so they have to do it with Marvel again.
Yeah, that's a dick move.
Yeah, if they are doing that, then that's...
Mm. Well, yeah, that's the rumor that there's going to be no X-Men characters in Marvel vs. Capcom. But next year we also have Injustice 2, so we've got the Mortal Kombat guys making Injustice, and we have the Capcom guys doing Marvel. So,
In general think that the Mortal Kombat guys do a better job, but
yeah,
we'll see.
Ian, your next piece of news, please.
My next piece of news, this little game teaser trailer.
Oh, yes, okay.
Yeah, I don't know if you watched this or not. Death Stranding.
No, I didn't watch that.
So, it's a game coming out by... And please forgive me for my terrible pronunciation.
Hideo Kojima.
There you go. Much better than my attempt.
What were you going to say?
Yeah, Hideo Kojima.
Hideo. You're a Hideo Kojima. Yeah,
fucking hideous.
He did the Metal Gear Solid series.
Yeah, he's done a lot. He's very well known in the gaming community.
Yeah.
Doesn't mean I can say his name properly.
Hideo Kojima.
Hideo. Anyway, so it's going to have Mads Mikkelsen in it.
Yep, who is Hannibal.
Hannibal, he's also in the new Rogue One movie.
Yep.
Doctor Strange. Doctor Strange, okay.
Yep.
Mind blank. And it's also going to have Norman Reedus in it.
Walking Dead.
Yeah.
Daryl.
So we had a little kind of tease separately with him in it.
Mm.
Every tease trailer thing that we're getting at the moment for this game is confusing as fuck, and I have no idea what this game is about, so there's not much to say other than all the names that are tied with it.
That's pretty Guillermo much your day.
Yeah, and Guillermo del Toro. Guillermo del Toro is writing it, or has written it.
He's a director?
You don't know Guillermo?
I know the name. I can't think of any movies he's done, though.
Hellboy.
Oh, yeah, we watched that fucking video. Oh, yeah, okay.
He's done Hellboy, Pacific Rim.
Haven't seen Pacific Rim.
Pan's Labyrinth.
Haven't seen it.
He's done a lot of shit, basically.
Okay. Cool.
So big names tied up with this movie, and as little as it does show us in these teaser trailers, it fucking looks awesome. I just want to know what's happening there. PlayStation only, of course, because it's
Hideo Kojima, yeah.
Hideo. All right, your next piece of news.
Well, speaking of Mads Mikkelsen, movie he did, Doctor Strange. Doctor Strange is the highest box office for a single standalone Marvel character. So, Doctor Strange made $616 million in the box office, and Iron Man made $585, and Ant-Man made $520. So, Doctor Strange has the highest box office for a standalone Marvel character.
Does it deserve it, you reckon? Do you reckon it's better than...
The first Iron Man film?
Yeah.
Yeah, I do. The first Iron Man film, it's a great film, but it's not in my top three. It's good.
But at the same time, Doctor Strange didn't really have a particularly interesting story. Didn't have anything special about it. It wasn't a bad movie by any... Like, it was a great movie, but the story was very much dumb. And it was very similar, in a sense, to the Iron Man story.
Mm. It was.
Plus, at the time, you got to realize, you know, Doctor Strange coming in now already has all the cinematic universe behind it and all these viewers seeing all these movies.
Yeah, true.
A lot easier now to make your money than when Iron Man first came out. Because Iron Man started this genre. So, very hard to compare when there was nothing backing up Iron Man at the time.
Compare the pair when there are no pairs?
If Iron Man came out now, I reckon you might find it to do even better. Because you've already got...
So, doing an Avengers film without Iron Man.
Well,
two Avengers films and the Civil War.
Yeah.
Captain America versus...
I'm just saying, if to come in this late in the game, when you've already got, you know, all these listened viewers, rather.
True. But also, the impressive thing is that Doctor Strange is, popularity-wise, isn't as high as... Is that of an Iron Man.
Yeah.
So that's pretty cool.
Yeah. Although Iron Man at the time as well wasn't, you know, when that first came out, he wasn't a huge name person. He wasn't like Captain America. Everyone knows the name Captain America, but Iron Man, like, obviously people in the comic book circle knew it. But, you know, everyday people didn't really know it as well. There wasn't cartoons of that in the 70s or whatever.
Of Iron Man?
Yeah.
Yeah, there was.
I thought it was a movie.
No, there was a cartoon of the Iron Man show.
Oh, yeah. Either way. Wasn't as popular as, like, the Spider-Man cartoon.
No, it wasn't as popular as them, yeah.
The Captain America cartoon. Yeah, those things to set up.
Okay, what's your next piece?
Next piece of news, Bulletstorm, full clip.
Did you play the original Bulletstorm game?
I played a little bit, yeah. I know you had it, and I think I was going to get it in one of those ones I'd never ended up getting. Did play it a bit. I think I borrowed it off you.
Made by the Gears of War guys.
Yeah, what was his...
Cliff Bleszinski.
Cliff, thank you.
I believe it was.
Cliffy B.
Cliffy B. And the story was very generic in relation to...
It was a, yeah, an action testosterone shooter.
It was a testosterone shooter, but yeah, very true. It did get a bit repetitive after a while, but when you got the new weapons and mixed things up, it was pretty cool.
So basically, it's a remaster, but it's also got little additions in. It's going to have Duke Nukem in it.
Duke Nukem replaces the main character.
Really? Is that how they're doing it?
Yeah. So it's like a special mode where you can play the whole story again, but instead of playing the main character as... I can't remember the character's name, but the main character, you play it as Duke Nukem.
Which kind of fits, because that game is...
Testosterone.
Yeah, it's very similar in the feel of the game.
Hmm. The game wasn't bad. Like, I didn't mind it, but it was one of those ones that does get a bit repetitive, like, after a while.
Yeah.
But still...
And it didn't really... I found that the game also didn't really know if it wanted to be funny action-y or whether it wanted to be, like, a serious action game.
Yeah, it did mix that up a lot.
Sometimes it was, like, it was confused with itself.
Hmm.
Had an identity crisis.
Like a dino crisis?
Yeah, but not... It was good.
Yeah. yeah. Do you reckon you'll get it?
I don't know. It depends how much it is, and I'll probably wait for the reviews as well, to be honest with you. I don't know how well it holds up now today as well.
Wait for a 2 for $50 or something. It was a very pretty game.
It was a pretty game, and they've cleaned it up again more, so it's, and it looks pretty good.
Yeah.
Still looks good by today's standards with it being cleaned up, but at the same time, the gameplay might, you know, a lot of these games that get remade, and then you realize it doesn't really hold up as well as it used to.
Mm.
But... Moving on, your next piece of news.
Next piece of news is actor Ron Glass, who plays Shepard in Shepard Book and Firefly, passed away last week at the age of 71.
Yes.
We found that out just after we finished recording as well.
Yeah, sad news. Do you want to tell us about some of your favourite moments, since you're such a huge Firefly fan?
Yes. Favourite episode is when the Malcolm Reynolds, Nathan Fillion's character, accidentally gets married. And he doesn't believe it, and Shepard Book comes out and pulls out, like, his sort of, his universal glossary Bible, and says, like, did you dance with her? Yes. Did she offer you a drink? Yes. Did she, like, put a crown of thorns on your head? Yes. Then you're married. That's their tradition. And he's like, fuck. He's like, don't you deflower her. You don't want to be married. You're not allowed to sleep with her. And he's like, there's a special place in hell for people like you. So Shepard Book was a really, really cool character. Really, really, it was sort of the central character, because he joins the audience. He starts with the audience, so the character's already set up on the first episode, and Shepard Book is the character that starts, like, I'm new, I'm going onto this ship just to travel, and he helps us get introduced to all these characters.
Yeah.
So he was sort of the starting point with the audience. It was really cool.
Yeah. Sad news, but.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes. Your next piece of news.
My next piece of news. We got another look at some more Zelda Breath of the Wild.
Breathe of the Wild.
Breathe. So now we actually get to see the world more so. We get to see some of the towns and dogs.
Dogs.
We saw some dogs in there, which is really cool, seeing animals. And we also got a look at after some, whatever it is that attacks everything. The towns all get destroyed and everything, and what they look like afterwards as well.
Okay.
So it looks like some cataclysmic kind
of... Is it still a male Link, or wasn't there talk of a female Link?
No, it's a male Link. I don't know what all ever happened with that. I think that's just, like, with everything else going on at the moment, let's just make every male a female kind of thing going on.
Oh, okay.
But, yeah, it's definitely still a male, as far as I know, or can tell, because he's got his long blonde hair, as always, so always hard to tell, but...
Does he ever... Isn't... Is this the game or one of the previous games where he actually gets a voice?
No. Well, we still don't have a voice for him. I was under the impression that maybe we might get a voice this time around, but doesn't look like we're getting a voice.
Yeah.
Still, which is a shame, because I, you know, it'd be nice to have him have a voice. It, I think it would fit the world as well to actually have voice acting in it.
Mm. But,
oh well.
Oh well.
Yeah. So it looks like about halfway through, the same thing as like, or not quite halfway through, maybe a third of the way in or something. Like with Ocarina of Time, you have something cataclysmic kind of happens and everything gets turned. So in Ocarina of Time, you become an adult.
Yeah, the world, the time sword.
Yeah. The time temple, and yeah, you become an adult. So it looks like something like that's going to happen again in this one about halfway through, because we see all this pretty towns and everything, and then we see this purpley black
thing.
Evil things.
You know? Gandalf.
Probably.
Is he, does he come back throughout the series, or?
He's like the villain in every game.
Oh, okay.
So, kind of a lot to explain, but yeah.
Okay.
Basically, we see all these towns and then they get destroyed, so it makes me think about halfway through or something.
Something will happen towards the very start or something, yeah. Yeah.
Like in a lot of the other Zelda games, you have like the light world and the dark world kind of things as well, so.
Okay.
Be interesting. Wait and see, but definitely looks pretty.
Mm.
Now we, I think, get solid proof that it's going to come out both the NX and the Wii U, because at the end of the trailer it has both, but.
Oh, okay.
We pretty much already knew that anyway, but now it's out there, solid.
The NX being the Switch.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Sorry, the Wii U and the Switch.
Yeah. Ian, did you ever play a video game when you were a kid called Rampage?
No, I did not.
That was, you played as like either like a rip-off King Kong, Godzilla, whatnot like that, destroyed cities.
Oh, it does sound familiar, yeah.
They're making a movie of that.
How do you make a movie of that?
It's King Kong, Godzilla, but I don't know.
Aren't we already getting a King Kong, Godzilla? So now
yeah, so they're making a Rampage movie. With the original three characters, which was the giant gorilla,
yeah,
the giant lizard,
yeah,
and the giant wolf.
Oh, yeah, that's right. There was a giant wolf as well.
Yeah. So they're making a Rampage movie.
Oh, my God. It's going to be so retarded.
I've still got to see it.
I don't know.
And man. Hopefully they bring out, like, arcade classics on Xbox Rampage, because I will play the shit out of that.
Oh, God. I have a feeling this movie is going to be terrible. Just, like, real bad. You got giant creatures beating the shit out of each other in a city, essentially.
Yeah.
Do you know how much budget you need for that kind of shit?
Yeah. Or they just pull out the old video game and record that. It's a live stream.
It's going to be so bad. Ugh. All right.
That's my next bit. Go on.
Terrible, but all right. Last of Us Part 2. So this was announced this morning.
Yeah. You woke me up going, check your Facebook, watch all the trailers.
Yeah.
And this was one that I didn't watch.
Yeah. This is... Essentially, it doesn't show a lot. It obviously shows an older... Ellie? Forgive me.
Zoe. I
just got mind blank on her name.
No, was it Zoe?
What?
The character's name Zoe?
Yes. Oh God, it's been too long. yeah, basically, it was just a tease to, for the sake of saying, hey,
we're
actually making it. And it looks pretty, as we all expected.
Tell, for those of you who haven't played the game Last of Us, what's the story?
So Last of Us is a post-apocalyptic third-person adventure shooter.
Survival.
Yeah. Zombies, post-apocalyptic.
Not generic zombies, they're like weird, pollinated sort of
but
zombies.
The thing that made the first game so great was that it has like a really powerful story.
Yeah, the really story written... story was very good.
Beautifully told story, and like the characters and the voice acting are just beautiful.
I will agree with that, yeah.
I think obviously they'll have to put that kind of effort into this one, so I think that's why we haven't seen it for so long, because they're just so much hype to live up to.
Yeah.
Obviously, you got Game of the Year, and
it did have Game of the Year edition, didn't it?
Yeah.
You
got another piece of news?
Billy Dee Williams, Lando Calrissian, is going to play Two-Face.
He's going to play Two-Face.
Yeah.
I feel like I've heard this rumor before.
Now, he played Harvey Dent in the 1989 Batman film.
Yeah.
Okay. Right? We only saw him for, what, 2 minutes or so, but Billy Dee Williams was Two-Face. Harvey Dent. He's going to play Two-Face in the Lego Batman film.
Interesting.
That's awesome. And the Lego... They've shown what the Lego piece of Two-Face is, and it's a Billy Dee Williams.
That's pretty cool.
That's awesome.
So essentially he's playing the same character from...
The 89 Batman.
The 89 Batman movie, yeah.
How cool is that?
That's pretty cool.
That's really fucking stupid, though, that they went from Billy Dee Williams to Tommy Lee Jones, and apparently it's in the same universe.
Yeah, it's a bit strange, but at the same time, they always have a lot of these scenes going on. He was very cool at the first point in time in 89, coming off the back of Star Wars movies. And then he kind of did nothing, so it doesn't surprise me that they kicked him
off. He was in The Ladies' Man.
So he did nothing.
No. I like Billy Dee Williams.
So do I, but it didn't do anything for a while. Next piece of news?
Yep.
This is my favorite piece of news.
Oh, okay.
I can't wait for this.
Go on.
Crash Bandicoot.
Who?
Fuck you. Crash Bandicoot Remastered Trilogy. That's the sound of my hands rubbing together. That's the sound of I will throw money at you. This looks so good.
I did watch the trailer.
Yeah, and we were talking about this not too long ago, Obviously, rumors have been going on for ages. And we're talking about how on earth they're actually going to do a remaster because the graphics are so old.
Yeah.
That they basically have to remake the game from scratch.
Yeah.
And they basically have remade the game from scratch.
And it looks fucking amazing.
Looks really cool. I cannot wait to play this game.
The way that the trailer was like, it was like one character, two eyebrows. Yeah. Like two dynamic eyebrows, and like you see Crash's eyebrows. It's great.
So good. I can't wait. I hope they add to these games, though. Add a little bit more in, maybe,
I'd like a...
Because at the time, those games were really big.
Yes.
But now, they're quite basic. You don't have much other than the plain levels.
They'll just be the plain levels, yeah.
I think they might hopefully add something to them, like maybe skins, maybe like... extra levels, bonus things.
I can do what the Halo game did and have, like, the select button or the back button reverts it into, like, original graphics.
Maybe, that'd be pretty cool.
That's what the Halo franchise did.
Wouldn't be bad. I don't know if I'd switch that often, but I hope they add more to it because they're very basic games now.
Yeah.
So, either put more levels in or put in something new to it, like different characters or...
Like a tease for one of their own upcoming, like, we're making our own Crash Bandicoot game, here's a tease for one of our levels.
Yeah, or do something. Do something, add to the game so it's not just purely a remaster. Add some new content in.
Or it could be like how they did Gears of War HD, the first one, the remaster, the Ultimate Edition. It was like, if this does well, we'll do Gears 4, maybe. Well, they already were doing Gears 4.
Well,
but
pretty much that's what we know is going to happen with Crash Bandicoot.
Yeah.
We know that if it does well, that
they'll make another.
Sony's going to revamp it and make some more games. So that's what I want to see, though. I don't want to see just the same levels remastered. I want to see some new content.
I want to do... The one level I want to play again was the bridge one, where you had to... It was like a rickety bridge, like from Indiana Jones 2, and you had to jump on the wooden planks.
Yeah.
That was my favorite.
So one. Good. Out of all three... Oh, I don't know which of the games I like the most. Either two or three. One dated quite badly. It's still good, don't get me wrong, but 2 and 3 had, like, actual stories, and that's what was really cool about them.
Yeah. they made like, the evil version of Crash, like, the giant mutated version of them, or the giant, like, muscly version of them, didn't they?
I have no idea what you're talking about.
Crash Bandicoot.
I don't know if that was in 1, 2, and 3, evil version of Crash.
I thought it was.
Well, I could be wrong.
Mm-hmm.
In Cortex, basically, is the villain of all three.
Your mate.
Yeah.
US voice actors are returning for Dragon Ball Super. I had to put that in my news.
Just cause.
Yeah, they're all confirmed to return.
Well, that's good, because I'm sure they're really busy doing all that other stuff.
Yeah.
What else do they do?
The dude who does the voice of Goku, Sean Schemmel.
Never heard of him. Go on.
He does one of the voices of, Ed and Eddie. He does one of the Ed's voices. So someone...
Ed and Eddie isn't still going.
I know,
so what is he doing?
I don't know.
Nothing.
He's doing video game voiceovers for Dragon Ball games.
Yeah, pretty much.
But yeah, they're all returning.
Well, that's good though.
Yeah.
This would be really weird having somebody else's voices in it.
Yeah, yeah. I'm looking forward to it. I'm watching Super. I will not watch Dragon Ball in the Japanese audio.
Yeah, no, that'd be... No.
That'd be a waste of time.
Alright, I've only got one more piece of news. And you know what it is.
Okay.
So, do you want to... Finish your news up.
Alright, well, yeah, we'll leave yours to the end then. We have the PlayStation 3 games for this month. Now, I didn't do it last week, because it wasn't announced last week. It's announced this week. So, PlayStation 4 gets Stories, The Path of Destinies, and Invisible Ink. Sounds great! I know what they are.
But we mentioned it, and that's what matters.
Yep. Kathleen Kennedy, the LucasArts president, confirms there will be no Rogue One sequel. She's already lied to us. But that's episode four. we have some listeners in the US. Howdy. We have some listeners in Germany. How do you say hello in German? Guten Morgen. That's good morning.
Guten Tag.
Guten Tag. Hello. and we have some listeners in Australia. G'day. Ridley Scott, my last piece of news before we go into yours, was tweeted in a photo of Alien Covenant, and it is the set of the first Alien film with the space jockey. And it looks exactly the same. It could be a different set, but it looks exactly the same as the first one.
Well, was that not in Prometheus anyway?
No, because it was a different ship.
True.
So I think this Alien Covenant movie could have the original ship.
The actual ship that lands on...
LV-426.
Thank you.
Someone knows their alien history, someone does not.
Give me a second. You just jumped in. I was going to get it.
Grandma talking. yeah, all right. Let's go on to probably the biggest piece of news we've got.
If you've been on our Facebook page this morning, well, it won't be this morning by the time this podcast comes out, but... If you've been on our Facebook page in general...
If you haven't, get on it.
Yeah. You'll see Guardians of the Galaxy Volume 2 teaser trailer. Another one.
It wasn't a teaser trailer, it was a full trailer, wasn't it?
I don't think it was a full trailer.
Anyway,
another trailer for Guardians of the Galaxy.
Yep.
We got a lot more look at. A lot more look?
Yep.
A lot bigger look?
A lot bigger look. A lot bigger look. We got a bigger look.
We got a better look.
There you go.
Yep. We got a lot better look at.
A lot baby. Better look.
Baby Groot.
Not English.
No, I can't English that. Too hangover.
Hangry over.
Baby Groot.
Yep.
He likes to push buttons.
Yeah, so premise of the trailer is just setting up, you know, a little bit of story, bit of gags here and there.
Yeah.
And it's essentially Rocket telling Baby Groot, do not push this button, because this will make a bomb go off. And then Groot tries to push it, and he's like, no. He tries to push it again, no. And then Rocket turns away. He comes back and there's Groot running off with the bomb device running away. So it looks pretty funny, but I have to say my favourite part in the trailer is the very end with Drax.
Oh, yeah.
I lost my shit aloud. You feel love. What? No. Sexual love for her. Drax is probably my second favourite character.
He's actually quite good character.
He's my favourite standalone, because you can't have Rocket as a favourite standalone because he compliments Groot.
Yeah, at the same time, you couldn't have Drax by himself either, because it's not funny, because it's not playing off real characters who, you know, make sense. He's funny because he's so dry compared to what everyone else says. Him by himself would not be funny. He's the Deadwood. In a comedy duo, he would be the Deadwood.
So, very, very... good look. Very good soundtrack. They've probably released their first song.
I was going to say the soundtrack. Finally, we get to listen to some of the new songs we might be getting.
Mm.
And this song was good.
Yeah, we're not going to spoil it for you because we can't remember the song.
Yeah. But it was good. It was good. It was like childhood memory song. Listen to Gold 104 in the car with Dad.
Oh, yeah. Getting McFlurries.
But that's it for news.
Really, really looking forward to Guardians 2.
Yeah, and Guardians 1 is probably my favourite Marvel movie.
Sorry, we also have a first look at the Thor teaser poster.
Oh, yeah, we did have
that. There was Hulk with his iconic helmet and hammer, but also Thor did not have his hammer. He had two swords.
True.
He might have had his hammer taken off him, as well as he's wearing his helmet.
Mm.
I hope he wears his helmet. I like his Thor in his helmet. He looks stupid without the helmet.
He looks fine without the helmet.
I prefer him with his helmet.
The helmet would be cool, though.
And we also have, next week, I'll be reviewing the last DLC for Battlefront. The trailer came out this week for Rogue One.
Yes, so we'll wait and see what that does with bated breath, I'm sure.
Yes. Anyway, we have a list. As always.
Yes, being this week's theme.
The theme of this weekly theme. I'm Ken Brockman.
And what is the theme?
Aliens.
Aliens. And why is it aliens?
Because we had a birthday.
We did. Happy birthday to you.
Keep going.
Happy birthday. All right, I've done enough.
So we had a couple of good birthdays this year. I've wrote down a couple, but we're focusing on one. Now, 50 years, we had Good, the Bad, and the Ugly. That's 50 years this year.
Wow.
as well as Dracula, Prince of Darkness, which is Christopher Lee. 18 years old is Mulan, Bugs Life, The Big Lebowski. Ants and Bugs Life came out in the same year.
Yeah.
I didn't know that.
That's why everyone got so confused, because they're like the same movie.
The Psycho remake, Small Soldiers, Wedding Singer, and the Rugrats movie. 40 years old is Rocky and Taxi Driver. 21 years old, fucking awesome, Toy Story, GoldenEye. 7 great movies. I'm going to keep the great movies rolling. Waterworld. Waterworld.
Horrible movie.
Power Rangers with Ivan Ooze. Batman Forever. Die Hard 3.
Yeah, that's
yeah.
Good. Yeah.
Jumanji. Oh, did I tell you my first
lunch? That was a good year for movies.
Yeah. Ace Ventura 2 and Get Shorty.
Wow.
Good year for movies.
That was a very good year for movies.
That's a vintage year.
Toy Story, GoldenEye, 7 fucking awesome movies.
30 years, we have Crocodile Dundee. Your mate.
Is that my mate?
Because you're Australian. I know someone who'll enjoy this. The 1986 Transformers movie.
Gonna sing the song.
No.
You got the touch.
I don't have the touch, and I'm not daring you to do it. Top Gun.
Yeah.
1986, the year of the...
Oh, yeah. Yeah, we did figure it out.
Ian figured it out as we were watching a movie, yeah.
1986, year of the aviators.
Yeah, they were in fucking high fashion then.
Every single movie.
Ferris Bueller's Day Off.
Yeah, I wonder if he wears them in that. Somebody surely wears the aviators in that.
Oh, yes. Yeah, someone does wear aviators in that. The Fly.
Yep.
I haven't seen that. Have you seen that?
I know it.
I haven't seen it.
You know it.
I know it. I haven't seen it.
Yeah.
Top Gun, we've already said. And what makes this theme of this week, this theme's weekly theme, is Aliens turn 30.
Happy birthday.
To you.
Hence this week's theme, Aliens Week.
The weekly theme of this week's theme. also, Rush Hour is 18 years old, but it's Rush Hour.
Rush Hour. You didn't mention Rush Hour, but you felt the need to mention Batman Forever, Ace Ventura 2, which is essentially Ace Ventura 1, but... yeah, alright, that one's alright.
sorry, but balls are showing. Bumblebee and Tuna.
Waterworld? You mentioned Waterworld.
It's a great movie. Millions of dollars spent on that film.
Great you movie. Mentioned the Psycho remake.
You see,
Psycho remake, Dutrum.
You see nipple. It's worth it.
No. Oh, whatever. Anyway.
Yes.
Happy birthday, Aliens.
Yes.
And because we love Aliens so much.
We base this themes episode on Aliens.
We're doing a whole week on Aliens.
Mm.
So we've got our top 5 Aliens in movies. And we're also going to have a retrospective review, a look back on the Aliens movie and tell you...
What we thought, what we picked up on.
Yeah.
Little bits of goofs and trivia. Mm.
First one being 1986, Year of the Aviators.
There you go. Ian noticed that, I think, as one of the characters was flying the plane. Hey, everyone's wearing aviators. Did Top Gun come out the same year? Yeah, it did. Oh my god. Anyway, let's move on to our top 5, shall we? Mumbo number 5. Here they come, Mr. Johnson, the Men in Black. yeah, so coming in at number 5, we have Edgar, played by, I didn't know this, Vincent D'Onofrio.
Kyle, if you didn't know this.
Well, his face is fucked up, that's why I didn't know.
Cockroach Man.
Sugar and water. More. More. And then he doesn't say more, just goes, yeah, I didn't know that was Vincent D'Onofrio. I expected him to be big, bald, fat, and, you know, caving someone's head in with a car door.
Such a cool villain, though, because... Well, I guess we'd never seen anything like that at
Quite
the time.
Quite like it.
Yeah, at the time. Now, it's a little bit done.
I guess. A giant cockroach that's gone into the body of a human and...
Yeah, and when he rips open the back of his head and it, like, comes out when he sheds the alien skin thing.
Yeah, that was cool.
It was really cool.
Mm. That was probably... A very commercialized, like, alien, funny sort of film that I can think of. At least, because I grew up watching it as well.
Yeah, exactly. I can't think of anything similar.
I had the soundtrack when I was a kid. I had the VHS, and it was the special edition. So, like, the case and the VHS was green around the rims.
Oh, yeah.
So, I had that. And I told Ian, as we were getting sound clips, that I think it was when I was in prep. So,
5 or 6 years old. They had a talent show, and I dressed up in a suit with sunglasses and danced to the Men in Black theme with backup dancers.
So bad.
It was great.
So bad.
Yeah. It's a great song. Getting jiggy with it.
Get jiggy with it. No.
Nod your head.
Oh, nod your head.
Like that.
Was that for number 2?
That was number 2.
Yeah.
And then number 3 was done by Pitbull.
Yeah.
That was terrible. Stupid.
That went real downhill.
Yeah, they should have had Will Smith do it.
Yeah.
Yeah. Anyway, so that's number 5 on our list. Pretty memorable.
Yeah, I mean...
The bad guy.
He killed his auntie, killed his uncle. I'm sorry, was that your auntie?
And there was the guy at the morgue who was killing all the flies.
Oh, yeah.
Don't do that. Or he steals like, what is it, a little bell or something like that from a cafe table, thinking the galaxy's inside it, and then he gets inside the van and he can't open it, can't find it. Where is that? And you just hear the van start.
So good.
Good movie.
So many good moments in that.
The whole series is a good set of movies.
Well, 3 is not good, but all right.
All right. Well, then, shall we move on to number 4, Mr. Johnson?
Numero 4.
For your eyes only.
Coming in, number 4, Mr. Johnson.
Elliot. No? You? Tell me you haven't seen... No. You've seen this, yeah?
No.
Oh my god. God, give me the strength.
I know the figure of E.T. I don't know the story of the movie, but what makes the matter even worse is I had E.T. bedsheets as a kid.
Oh my god. And you've never seen E.T.?
No.
Oh, man. There are so many iconic movies that you need to watch.
Well, I just bought 2 iconic movies.
Which ones?
Tusk.
Oh god. What was the other one?
From Dusk Till Dawn. Apparently From Dusk Till Dawn's a real... I saw the front cover for it and went, oh, that's that. I've seen the... My sister had a poster of it in her room when she was growing up. But I've never seen it.
Apparently, she probably hasn't seen it. Just like you had E.T. bed sheets and never saw it. Fucking retard.
What's the story of E.T.? You're going to have to do this one for me.
Basically, an alien gets left behind from a spaceship.
Okay.
And is kind of adopted by a little boy.
Okay.
As, like, a friend. But then the alien begins to die because it's away from its family.
Really?
Yeah. So it's trying to contact its home planet to get picked up. And, yeah, basically, the boy and the alien make a really strong relationship together. And
sort of like Eleven in Stranger Things?
Yeah. Essentially, yeah.
Would you say that's where E.T. got its inspiration from? Stranger Things?
Yeah, E.T. definitely copied Stranger Things.
Yeah. Yes, unfortunately, this is one of those iconic movies that I haven't seen.
It's a good movie. Steven Spielberg, the Mexican equivalent.
Mexican equivalent.
Yeah, it's a great movie, as you can tell from the soundtrack.
John Williams.
Yeah.
Love John Williams.
80s as fuck sounding. But good movie. It's got a little baby Drew Barrymore in it, basically. Basically a baby.
Before she hit acid.
Yeah. Before she got old.
It's
worth a watch.
Are there any bad
it's
guys?
It's family friendly. No, not really. Oh, there's like bullies.
There's bullies.
Yeah.
The bad guys are bullies.
But a lot of the story comes from like the heartfelt stories when the alien starts dying.
Okay.
So, like, obviously it's like his best friend and he's dying. And like his house gets like taken over by the government because they find out that he has an alien.
Oh, okay, so the government's bad guys.
Kind of, yeah.
Okay.
It's a very hard movie to explain, but, like, it's good. It's a family movie, obviously.
All right, well, I might need to take a look at it next time I stroll down to the next JB.
Yeah, it's just, you know, one of those alien movies that the alien's a good guy, and we don't really, particularly on our list, have a look at our list, they're all villains.
Oh, look. No, drop the phone. I wouldn't say number 2's a villain.
Really?
Did you say number 2 is a villain?
Yeah.
No.
For the movie?
He's not a villain, Ian. My phone is fine. Not like Zoe's phone. So, is that all? Anything else you'd like to add to number 4, E.T.?
Watch it. Have a childhood. You're dead to me until you've seen that and the Blues Brothers. What was the other movie that you haven't seen? There's some other movie you haven't seen as well.
Yeah, because we were thinking about it in JB Hi-Fi. I know it's Blues Brothers and I own it.
I can't remember. There's a bunch of movies you haven't seen that you should watch.
It was driving us nuts because we were looking for it in JB.
The Who's Back the Puns guys as well. There's some movie that we were talking about that you hadn't seen.
Oh, when we were drinking with them.
Yeah. Fuck, can't remember it now.
It could be John Wick, because you were talking about John Wick.
I wouldn't say that's like a need-to-watch movie, though. But there's plenty of old movies that you haven't seen.
Mm-hmm. Anyway, should we move on to number three?
Numero Triero?
Triero.
Triero.
Tree, 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 tree. ABC, easy as 1, 2, 3. Three on our list, Mr. Johnson. Get your head away from my nuts.
John Carpenter's The Ting. Oh, there's an H in it.
Every ting happens for a reason. Go on.
What?
This is one of your movies as well.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And yours. Have you not seen it?
I have
seen it. You have seen it.
You bought it for me for a Christmas present. You
John did. Carpenter's The Thing. Awesome movie. We've spoken about it before in our podcast.
Horror Week, I believe he was mentioned.
Yeah. Basically, spaceship crash lands, and it's an alien that needs to, I don't know how to explain it.
Replicate?
Yeah.
No. The alien doesn't speak. It just kills.
More like a creature, yeah.
Yeah. It's more of like a thing.
Yeah. It's a thing. You know, with the thing and the stuff.
Can you repeat the things about the stuff? The things.
It takes over human bodies and replicates them.
Yeah. And when it finds out it's been caught, it pretty much kills everything.
Yeah, kills the shit out of it. Basically, it just wants to survive.
Hmm.
So, it's pretty cool. We had the prequel. Oh, God, it might have been a few years ago now.
2011.
Yeah, 2011. There you go. 5 years ago.
With Mary Elizabeth Winstead.
Yes. And the original movie.
Stop yawning.
Ugh, you're supposed to talk when I'm yawning.
No,
God.
No. I like pointing at your flaws. Just like you pointing at my flaws.
Alright, fat boy.
Fat bald boy.
Yeah, the original one by John Carpenter. Starring Kurt Russell. Thank you. Ugh.
Russell Brand.
Russell Brand.
Oh, jeez, there's aliens everywhere. What are we gonna do?
Oh, my God. You sound like you're from London.
Good line.
Yeah.
Anyway, so we've talked about The Thing before.
We have. So I don't know how much more to go into it.
Essentially, it's an alien that comes out from space and just randomly starts killing people that live in the Antarctic. It lands in the Antarctic and goes up to like a research group.
Yeah. Pretty cool.
Pretty fucked up. Very mutilation, grotesque sort of thing. Like when the guy's trying to give him CPR and his hands go through his chest.
Pretty cool.
Yeah, it's pretty fun. But going from number three, we go to number two, one of our personal favourites.
Yeah. Dilly-dilly-din. Building them castles in the sky, just the two, you and I.
That's right, Ian. You are one ugly looking mother. Stop hitting everything.
Yeah. That's not ready.
Coming in number two on our list is Predator.
The sexual predator.
Sexual harassment predator. So yeah, coming in number two on our list is The Predator.
Yes.
From the iconic movie Kindergarten Cop. No, from the movie Predator. John McTiernan, same director as Die Hard.
Yeah.
Little known fact.
Starring Arnold Schwarzenegger.
Carl Weathers. Jenny.
Jesse.
Jesse, the body Jenny.
Jenny, the body Ventura.
Yep. And at one point, the Predator isn't, but it was going to be played by Jean-Claude Van Damme.
Yeah. Apparently.
Lots of splits.
a lot of splits.
It's like instead of the Predator hiding in the trees, it's just between two trees with his legs split. Just like
this. I've heard a lot of different rumors about why he didn't end up being in it.
Go on.
One of which was he didn't want to be in it because his face was going to be covered up the whole time, so it wasn't worth it for his career and everything.
Oh, yep.
One of the other ones I heard was that he wasn't tall enough.
Yeah, he was small.
Yeah, and the Predator is very tall.
Yeah, it's taller than Schwarzenegger.
So a lot of different, like, hearing that it was him leaving and one of them saying, like, they didn't want him, so...
And was it you who said John Carpenter decided to put the mandibles on the Predator?
Yeah, I think it was John Carpenter. No, I can't remember, but... Yeah. Was it John Carpenter? James Cameron, yeah.
Mm.
Apparently.
Mm. Mm. Anyway, so...
Such a good movie. Do you want to go through the premise?
Yes, because I actually know this movie. Predator is essentially... The main plot story is... Arnold Schwarzenegger is a commander for a group of specialists. They get sent into the jungle to retrieve hostages from a drug cartel.
Behind enemy lines.
Behind enemy lines. And they're not supposed to, you know, if you get caught, you know, you're dead, you know. Yeah. Sort of thing.
There is no rescue team.
Yeah. And essentially they get there and they find that the team before them have all been strung up and skinned and all their skin's missing, and then they essentially get the hostage and they decide to go back, you know, call a chopper and go back, and they realize they're being hunted by something, and it is known as the Predator.
Yeah.
Hmm.
So it's basically a bunch of commandos trying to
survive this creature they can't see. And the Predator is almighty and all-powerful, can even take Schwarzenegger on in a fist fight.
Yeah.
And beats
the shit out of him.
Beats the shit out of him.
Yeah.
The Predator's got some pretty... It's not very barbaric. It's got a bit more technology, but it's also very sort of ritualistic as well.
Yeah, so like futuristic space technology meets tribal warrior.
Yeah.
Essentially.
Yeah.
He can turn invisible, so he's got some
he's got
like
a cloaking device.
Gadgets.
He's got a cloaking device. He has...
cannon kind of thing.
He's got a shoulder cannon.
Shoulder cannon, sorry.
He's got wrist blades. He has a nuclear explosion device on his arm, so a bomb attached to his arm if he needs to use it.
Bomb.
He has a medical kit that he uses to take bullets out and sew himself back up. And he has his helmet, which is also a aiming reticule for his shoulder cannon, as well as different viewfinders for his helmet. And he can also do audio, record audio clips.
Yeah. He's also a podcaster.
Yeah, essentially it's got fluoro green blood.
Yeah.
Which is pretty cool. And this is my point. The Predator is not a bad guy. Because the Predator will only kill it's like hunting. The Predator isn't killing for fun, it's hunting people. Now it only hunts you if you can fight back. If you can't fight back, it leaves you alone.
Yeah, that's... Yeah.
So Predator won't come near you if...
In general, the creature itself is not a villain. It's just a... I don't know what you call it. A hunter.
Hmm.
And
it only comes to Earth...
In the story of this movie, the first movie, he's the villain.
Yeah. In Alien vs. Predator, he's the hero. and he only comes to Earth in hot climates.
Yeah.
So, in the second film, Predator 2, he comes to LA in the largest heat wave they've ever had, and the Predator rocks up in LA.
And definitely explains Alien vs. Predator being in the snow.
Oh, that was... That's a story for another time. I can explain that.
It's stupid.
I can explain it. Anyway, so essentially, yeah, the Predator is... It hunts you if you can fight back. If you've got a gun on you, it will go for you. If you don't have any weapons on you, it'll leave you alone. Which I thought was very cool. You've got the very iconic scene of the Predator landing in the water, and you see it for the first time because its cloaking device malfunctions.
Yeah.
And it's got dreadlocks.
Very cool.
You love your dreadlocks.
I love the dreadlocks.
It's got the iconic fight with Schwarzenegger, the you one ugly looking man if you're okay. Yeah.
You quoted it wrong, but yeah, sure.
Yeah, well, I'm gonna fuck.
And get to the chopper.
Get to the chopper, yeah, get to the chopper is one
Government
of the...
Government got you pushing too many pencils.
Dylan! You son of a bitch. It's got a lot of good one-liners in it.
Yeah, it's very 80s.
Yeah, oh yeah. Apparently, what were you saying?
What
Jesse the Body...
this one movie come out?
Ooh,
that's a good question.
That's a good question. For another time now, off to bed.
I can't actually remember what year that is, because I think...
Predator film is 1987.
I'm pretty sure Schwarzenegger wears aviators in it.
He does.
And that's before
at the very start. 86.
Oh, 86? Is that the year that we're saying is?
Yeah,
obviously.
Yeah. Idiot.
Derp. Yeah, so the next year.
Oh.
So maybe it was 86 and 87.
Bit of news I remember. They are making another Predator film.
Really?
Yep. Schwarzenegger is rumoured to return just as like a cameo-y sort of thing, not as the main star. And the cinematographer they're using, so not the director, the actual cinematographer they're using, is the same cinematographer from Batman Superman.
interesting.
And the filming style was pretty good in that. At least, like, the camera angles, the lenses, and the shaders and stuff was pretty good.
I think it all depends on how good the story is. Because the Predator stories, since the first one, have been very downhill.
But you didn't mind Predators?
It was not great, though. It was not great.
The idea of them having, like, hounds and stuff was pretty cool.
Yeah, but at the same time, no. I think if they're going to make another Predator movie, they need to play on the story of this original movie, and that is a whole bunch of, like, commando beef guys who think they're the best in the world decide they want to take on a Predator.
Decide they want to take on
a Predator. I think that's the avenue they should take.
People so are being
the
killed.
The world's best hunters go out of their way because they hear maybe stories about Arnold Schwarzenegger. And they decide to go after Predator. Maybe that's how Arnold Schwarzenegger could cameo in it, is he takes them.
Or he, like, warns them or whatever.
Yeah. He gives them the advice.
Could be good. I reckon if we saw Schwarzenegger, would you like to see him scarred or something?
I think so. I think, obviously, maybe with, like, PTSD or something, and, like, maybe becomes, like, an alien conspiracy nut or something.
Oh, yeah, that could be cool. Yeah, so essentially, yeah, the story of Alien is, sorry, not Alien, Predator is the whole people in the jungle, creature comes, starts killing people, picking people off from the team one by one, so the first guy to go is the radio guy, the guy who's got the radio is the first one to die, then Jesse the Body Ventura gets killed with a big hole in his chest.
Yeah, and who's the guy that gets his arm shot off?
Carl Weathers. Carl Weathers gets his arm shot off while he's firing a gun, and the gun's still firing as his arm falls off.
Yeah. So cool.
And then you've got Billy, the Native American, who you just hear him scream.
Yeah, you don't even know what happens there.
Oh, he gets his spine pulled out of his back.
Does he?
Yeah. That's where you see the spine go out of his back. And he, like, polishes the skull and the spine.
Yeah, he's already dead at that stage, right?
Yeah, yeah. But that is, that's number two, but we also have some honorable mentions.
Some honorable mentions?
Oh, yes. Ian, would you like to go through some of them?
Yeah.
Can you see that?
No. so, some honorable mentions for Best Aliens.
Yes. Get closer to the microphone so people can hear you.
We've got Kang and Kodos, your mates.
Yep, Simpsons.
Roger from American Dad.
Yep.
You've got Zoidberg, your choice, from Futurama.
I wanted to put him on the list.
Whoop! Whoop, whoop, whoop. You've got the aliens from Mars Attacks.
I didn't mind that movie.
I hated it. Classic Tim Burton.
Totally. Ruins everything.
Yeah, fucking
Batman.
Everyone loves Tim Burton, but come on, Batman's one of the only movies he's done that's half decent. Everyone's gonna hate me for this, but he's overrated.
Yep.
Paul from the movie Paul.
Yep, one of my favorite movies.
It's a pretty good movie, actually. That was good.
Sigourney Weaver was a bad guy in it as well.
Yeah. You've got the War of the Worlds aliens. We kind of have to put them in there because they're iconic. Let's be honest. District 9, the prawns. You haven't seen it?
No, I've got it on Blu-ray. I haven't seen it.
And you've got the species, the rapist aliens.
Now, the species is, it's an alien that escapes from a lab and wants to reproduce its kind, because it's the last of its kind or something, isn't it?
Yeah, in the first one?
Yeah.
Yeah, I think it's like a girl. She doesn't know she's an alien, and it's kind of weird. It's a weird story. But yeah, basically, all the movies are generally about the alien wanting to reproduce.
I think I saw Species 3 once when I was a kid, and I just...
They're basically alien porn.
Yeah.
It's great. They get progressively pornier as they go on.
So I need to watch these?
Yeah, so set aside some time by yourself.
set aside some time by yourself and literally set aside a box of tissues. Oh, that's
if you're
nice.
Into that kind of thing.
Anyway, we've gone through our top five and we've come to our number one. And clearly this makes number one for a very,
I think this
very
is very obvious. Movie. Surely you guys all know what's coming up as number one.
But let us move to number...
Numero unero.
You need to stop that.
Number one.
One is the loneliest number that you'll ever do.
Away from her, you bitch!
And number one.
The one, the only, the alien.
Also known as a xenomorph.
Yeah. Spelt with an X.
X-E-N-O-M-O-R-P-H.
Yeah, because alphabet, that's why.
Xylophone. So, this is 30 years old this year?
Yes. So, maybe... Because we'll be reviewing Aliens in our upcoming segment, our retrospective review, Let's just talk about the alien itself.
Yes, so you know a lot about in relation to, you're an Aliens fan over a Predator fan, I know that much.
I do like Predator though. Fucking love Predator.
But out of the two of them you prefer the Alien.
I prefer the movie Alien over Aliens.
But tell us about the life cycle. Some people haven't seen these films. Some people need to watch these films.
Yeah, so basically...
Just the first two.
Essentially, if you want to think of it, it's kind of like an ant hive. Beehive. Bees have hives.
I don't want your honey. Oh, the bees!
You've got a queen who gives birth to eggs. And it's often these eggs that people stumble across.
Yes.
So out of these eggs... a little alien creature comes out of it called a facehugger. Hence the name.
Facehugger.
Facehugger.
Designed by the great late H.R. Geiger.
Hey, Geiger. Hey, Geiger. 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 So basically, it grabs onto your face and impregnates you.
It rapes your face, pretty much.
It rapes your face.
Yeah.
So you'll be asleep for quite some time while it's attached to your face because you can't get it off.
2 hours? 3 hours? I think you fall asleep.
Yeah.
I'll Google it.
It stays attached to your face for quite some time. And it grabs around your throat, so if you try to take it off, it will kill the host.
Yes. The facehugger sort of got like two lung-like pockets on each side of it that when you breathe, you can actually see them inflate and deflate.
Yeah, and little kind of fingers that grab around the head and the tail that wraps around the throat. Yes. So essentially, after several hours of the facehugger being on your face, hugging you...
I can't find how long it has to go on you. Has to be on your face for.
Eventually it dies, essentially.
Yes.
Eventually the facehugger dies, it drops off, and the person wakes up.
Yeah, after a few hours after it, there you go.
Yeah.
Drops
off, and then you'll wake up.
And it dies.
You think you're fine. You might be going and eating some breakfast at a table with a whole bunch of people.
Go through that iconic scene. You know the trivia on that.
Essentially, this scene in the very first Alien movies is very famous because everyone rocked up to shooting on this day, and nobody knew what was going to happen. They looked at the crew, everyone was wearing raincoats, basically, and they're like, what's going on here? So they started filming the scene, they just started eating breakfast at a table. And then the actor who had the facehugger on it in previous scenes, who was now fine...
Kane,
started convulsing, coughing... Unable to breathe, convulsing, drops onto the table, shaking, and then all of a sudden, something starts...
The actors try to secure him and put him flat on the table, thinking he's having an actual fit.
They thought he was actually having a fit or choking or something. And then all of a sudden, something starts bursting out of his chest, crushing his ribs on the inside out.
Mm.
Essentially a chest burster is what it's called.
Yep.
Bursts out of his chest. Blood. Guts and stuff.
We saw a dildo version of this at Sexpo.
Yeah. So it comes out of the chest and runs off. Eventually that chest burster grows up to be an alien.
Now, apparently the characteristics of the person transfer onto the alien as well, I've read.
Really? I wasn't aware of that.
Mm. I've also read here that it can be up for up to from 20 minutes to 16 hours to when the chest burster bursts out of your chest.
That's a very big difference.
Yeah. Well, I think it was Alien vs. Predator 2. It's a dad and his son get attacked by facehuggers, and then they wake up, and then they see the facehuggers, and since they see the facehuggers, they burst out of their chest.
Yeah, it's weird.
Yeah. Hence to say, Alien vs. Predator 2 is pretty shit. Yes. I like the burp.
That's disgusting.
Just like a facehugger. But yes, it goes on to becoming an alien. Now, there are different types of aliens. You've got the drone, which is from the first Alien film, with a big smooth head. You've got the warriors, which have a rigid head. You have the dog-like ones, which is Alien 3. And then you have the queen, which is fucking huge.
Yeah, it's a huge bitch. Behemoth.
Mm-hmm.
Who lays the eggs.
Yes. And all of these movies star Sigourney Weaver.
All of them. Except for the Alien vs. Predator movies.
No. But they're not real.
Yes. But yes, essentially, that's what they are. And they are fucking awesome. And you should watch those movies.
Mm.
And that's why they made our number one.
And that's why it's made the theme this week.
Yes. So, keeping on the theme of aliens.
This theme this week, this weekly theme.
Yeah, we're going to move on to our retrospective review. To celebrate the Aliens movie 30th anniversary, we're going to have a look back on the Aliens movie.
Sit back, relax, and enjoy.
Movement!
Talk to me, Hudson!
I got signals. I got readings in front and behind.
There's nothing back here.
Look, I'm telling you, there's something...
They cut the power.
How could they cut the power, man? They're animals.
There's movement all over the place. 5 meters, man. 4.
Aliens. This time, it's war.
So this week, we went back and watched Aliens. Yesterday.
Yes.
I put a tease up on our... or you put the tease up, sorry, on Instagram of what we're watching. And one of our listeners was very excited that we were doing Aliens this week.
Who that?
Liam. Huh? Work. Someone from work. Very excited that we're talking about Aliens. But yes, Ian, what's the story of Aliens?
Essentially, Morgan Freeman crash lands on an isolated planet where he's forced to do voiceovers for all of eternity.
Does he get paid for them?
No.
Oh.
Yeah.
How does he survive on the planet?
Penguins. The penguins helped him, who he narrated their story.
Walruses?
In exchange for love. Obviously, this isn't the story of Aliens.
I just want to see how far he could go. Do you know the story? You should know the story of Aliens.
Mm-hmm. Take place just after the story of Alien. Sigourney Weaver's spaceship floating through space.
Yep.
For 50 years.
57.
Sorry, 57. 57 years. Ooh, I'm a nerd and I like to announce it.
Yeah.
Fuck you and your tattoos. Goldberg.
Just because I look good.
Sure.
Go on.
Aliens. Yes, Sigourney Weaver escapes the alien in the first Alien movie, floating through space in her sleeping pod for 57 years when she is found by another spacecraft.
Yes.
She's investigated for what occurred in the events of the first movie. And in the meantime, while she has been sleeping for 57 years...
Yes.
LV-426...
Yes.
...has begun terraforming, and some people have moved there.
Yes.
In which case, everything goes wrong, because they've stumbled across the spaceship in the first Alien movies, and people started to die.
That's basically the story of it, yeah.
Yeah. So Sigourney Weaver and the Colonial Marines, which is like Space Army.
Space Army, pretty much, yeah.
Go to LV-426 to investigate.
And shit happens.
Yes. And shit does happen.
Hmm. It's got some good actors. So, of course, we have Sigourney Weaver, who plays Ellen Ripley. We've got Michael Biehn?
Biehn?
Who plays Hicks.
Corporal Hicks.
Yep. We've got Lance Hendrickson, who plays Bishop. And who is the actor who plays fucking Hudson?
Fucking Hudson. That would be the one...
Paxton.
Yep.
Yes, so I've got a bit of trivia that I wrote down for this film as we were watching it. Would you like to know what some of the cool things are?
Yeah, let's go through some fun Aliens trivial facts.
Okay, so at the start of the film when Ellen Ripley is asleep in her pod, we see the grappling gun stuck in the bottom of the door from the first film.
Ooh.
We pointed that out.
From the better film, yeah.
Yep. I said it then. Amanda Ripley is Ripley's daughter, who died at the age of 67, I think it was. The young age, 6'7", who's the main character from the Alien Isolation game. Also, the photo that we see of it is Sigourney Weaver's real-life mum.
Is it?
Yeah.
Oh, interesting.
This was cool. So the set of the Alien Hive in Aliens was also used for Ace Chemicals in the 1989 Batman film, but they didn't take down the Alien Hive stuff, so when they came to film, they freaked out because they saw all the Alien Hive stuff was still there.
Really?
Yep. You have the filming of all the Marines, them eating and waking up in their space pods, was actually done at the end of production, so the actors could get to know each other and build a relationship.
At the end of it?
Yeah. So they filmed that scene last.
Why'd you do that at the end, though?
So the actors have all, like, worked together, and they've built a bit of a relationship, so that way the shooting of them, you know, joking around and stuff like that would seem more natural.
Okay.
So that was kind of cool. The scene where Newt falls down the air conditioning duct, the actress who plays Newt, Carrie Henn, kept deliberately screwing it up so she could keep going down the slide.
Really?
Yeah. So James Cameron pulled her aside and said, if you get it right, you can go down the slide as much as you want. So then she did the scene correctly, and then she just kept playing on the slide. The time countdown in the movie, so 15 minutes until the fusion reactor explodes is actually 15 minutes.
Oh,
and it's good. Actually 10 seconds when the sergeant says 10 seconds till we're on the ground, Marines, and it's actually 10 seconds. So it's a proper movie where they have proper countdowns.
Wow. That doesn't happen very often.
There are only 6 aliens in this film. 6 alien suits.
That doesn't surprise me. A lot of it does look very much the same.
The big alien queen puppet was too big to fit inside the elevator, so the tail was removed and the back of the elevator was removed for it to fit.
Wow.
Yeah. The flooring of the Sulaka, so that's the big main marine ship that's in space. Yep. The actual floor coverings was the set from the original Alien film.
Oh, that makes sense.
Mm. They ran out of flooring and they asked the production crew, do you have any flooring we could use? They're like, well, yeah, we've had the old Alien flooring sitting at the back of the warehouse for 7 years. Do you want to use that? They're like, yep.
Sure.
The liquid Bishop sprays out of his mouth is expired milk.
Expired milk. That's fucking
so gross. They left it out. He was going to just shoot milk out of his mouth as he gets ripped in half, but they apparently left it out and he got sick from it.
Yeah, that's gross.
Yeah.
Poor guy. But no wonder he died.
Well, as we were watching this film, Ian pointed out some great sci-fi things, though.
Yeah.
Sci-fi. Some great sci-fi things that may or may not happen now, may or may not happen in the future. So, Ian, I've written them down.
Yeah.
We have drinking coffee from custard bowls.
Yeah.
So explain that one.
So people no longer will in the future use mugs. Mugs will be obsolete because they're made from an inferior material. Material.
Yeah.
So people will now use glass and not like a normal glass. Oh, no. It has to be short, round, dessert. Custard mugs.
Ian got up and went to the kitchen. He went, do you want a cup of coffee? And he pulled out an actual custard bowl. you have GoPros on the side of the Marines' helmets.
Yeah, they foretold that one. Now everyone has a GoPro. Have them in the cars in case they get into car accidents and everything now.
Popped collars on suits.
Yeah, that's not going to take off.
So all the suit collars are actually popped upwards?
Everybody in that movie who was wearing a suit jacket, the top half of their collar was popped up. Looks stupid.
You can call people on business cards from video phones.
Yeah. So basically, before Skype existed, they had the idea that you could Skype people with their business card.
That was kind of a cool idea.
Kind of a cool idea, but at the same time, no.
Using a wristwatch as a tracking device.
Yeah, so we have tracking
devices. We got iPhones now.
Yeah, we got iPhones to do it now, but essentially, yeah, that's come true. We now have GPS on everything.
Motion trackers,
the army, everyone uses that.
This one's more of a quote. It's tactical smart missiles, phased plasma rifles, RPGs, electronic ball breakers, nukes, knives, and sharp sticks. That's one.
Is that sci-fi?
That's sci-fi,
yeah. Yep.
Right. Wheels made of metal.
Yeah. Yep, that car.
The APC.
Yeah. In the future, tires will no longer exist.
Aliens.
Aliens.
We have steering wheels that are two vertical rods or levers.
Yeah, because round wheels are obsolete. So from now on, everybody who gets into a car will be using levers instead.
You can explain this one, Ian, because I wrote this one down saying you can explain it. Space insurance.
Yeah, space insurance. So,
go on.
We were talking about this because...
Carter Burke, the bad guy from the film.
Yeah, the bad guy from the film basically says that, oh, we can't do that, you know, we can't blow up this whole place because the company's put so much money into this. And obviously, we pointed out that the company would have insurance.
Space insurance. I saw this
one.
The character Carter Burke wore this one as well. Space belt. On pants, so instead of normal belt around your pants, it's a space belt.
Which is essentially...
It was a bicycle helmet clip instead of a standard belt clip, and I'm like, that's pretty cool.
That's really gay. That's homeless, that's what that look is.
Sentry turrets?
Yeah, sentry turrets, which is, again, something that basically does happen now.
Smoke.
So much smoke used in this movie. Sci-fi.
Apparently one of the smokes they use in this film is now actually illegal to use in filming.
Really?
Yeah.
Why?
I don't know.
Causes people to die.
Probably two people.
So much smoke used in that movie, though. So much smoke. Because sci-fi.
Yeah. You've got see-through teeth on the alien.
Yeah.
Yes, on the alien queen, sorry.
As we know from, you know, mugs not existing anymore. Anything that's see-through, like glass and plastic, is sci-fi.
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 Our question as well, Ian and I asked this while we were watching the film, do you reckon the Colonial Marines could take on a Predator?
Yeah.
Because Schwarzenegger did by himself, but, you know, he did struggle, and his entire team got killed. But could the Colonial Marines take out a Predator? And we figured this out, they had infrared on their helmets, so they probably could find it.
Well, they could find it. Yeah. Predators have a lot more weaponry and everything as well.
Hmm. But we also noted some cheesy one-liners.
Very cheesy.
You hated the dialogue in this film.
Look, I've got a problem with James Cameron's dialogue in every movie.
Titanic.
Yeah, terrible.
Rose. Floating on a door.
Paint me.
Paint me.
Like one of your French girls.
Slapping a hand onto fogged up glass.
He doesn't do very good dialogue. He does very corny dialogue. He has great stories, don't get me wrong. And great visuals, great stories, but his dialogue... not the best.
Maybe you should have George Lucas write his dialogue.
Oh, much better.
Oh, yeah.
Ooh, you should be going to the Avatar planet.
You've got Eat This, when Corporal Hicks puts a shotgun in the alien's mouth and fires it at close range.
Yeah.
Idiot. You just saw it burn your friend alive, and then it's like, eat this with a shotgun. Anything Bill Paxton says.
Yeah.
We're fucked. What are we going to do? Game over, man. Game over. 17 days. We won't even last 17 hours.
Yeah, he's very corny.
Have you ever been mistaken for a man?
No.
No? Have you? They mostly come at night, mostly.
Yeah. There's some great corny dialogue in this movie.
Get away from her, you bitch.
It's probably one of the better lines.
And this isn't a cheesy one line, it's actually a thing I forgot to mention, that the scene where Bishop puts his hand over Bill Paxton's hand, does the knife trick?
Yeah.
They didn't tell Bill Paxton about that.
Really?
Yeah. So to get his initial fear.
But... it was fast-forward and everything anyway.
Well.
So it wouldn't have been that intense.
Nope. Oh, well. But that is our little goofs and trivia things that I found on Aliens. What did you think of the film as a whole, Ian?
On the whole.
Having a retrospective look back on the movie Aliens, still an awesome movie.
Yep.
Let's be honest. Got some great action. It took all the concepts from the first Alien movie and turned it into an action movie. For better or for worse in some sense.
Rather than Jaws in Space, which is what the first film was.
Yeah, which was good.
Mm.
Look, it's not perfect. It's not a perfect film. It's still, you know, the dialogue I've obviously touched on is extremely corny.
Yeah.
So in some parts it's very facepalm. Like, why would you say that? Why would you do that? It's also quite slow in some parts, but that's deliberate, I feel. To kind of build the suspense and everything. Like, the first Alien movie is obviously even slower, because that's the style of movie that it is.
Yeah, Alien doesn't kick in until the first 45 minutes.
Something like that, about half an hour in or something.
Mm.
So, this does a very similar thing. It's slow to start,
yep,
and then really gets into it, slows down again, and then gets into it again.
So, overall score, if we had to give this a, let's say... an alcoholic beverage review of some kind?
You haven't told me you're good and bad.
Oh, I'm sorry.
It's not just me.
Yeah.
Podcast, Ian.
Yeah.
And friend.
Your podcast. I'm the co-pilot.
Go on, tell me.
So...
The good, the bad, and the ugly.
Okay. What I liked about this film was I love the Colonial Marine aspect for it. As I said to Ian while watching, like, this movie makes me want to join the army a little bit. Like, I love the sort of the military aspect of it.
You couldn't survive.
Oh, no, I couldn't. That's not the question here. I wish they kept with that longer, because as soon as the aliens come out, the entire team is pretty much dead, except for 3 or 4 extra people.
Yeah.
So I would have liked more of a team dynamic and them getting picked off sort of slowly, rather than like a team of 15 people get taken out in the space of 5 minutes.
It happens very quickly and you can't see almost anything that happens.
They get grabbed and taken away, or they get exploded or whatever, but I'm like, just... have actually like 3 people die then, and have the guy who's carrying all the ammo get taken. So that was a cool aspect, but I would have liked more of that sort of squad-based dynamic a bit more.
Yeah.
So that I wish they did a little bit more of. I like the Alien Queen. That was great, but
it's clearly the best part. The Alien Queen, as soon as you get to the part where Ripley has to go into the tunnels to go and get Newt out,
yeah,
that's when that movie really becomes something iconic to me.
Yeah.
Before that, it's kind of a corny action movie. It's kind of dated poorly as well. But as soon as that happens, this movie really jumps up a huge notch.
Yeah, that's probably where you were saying yesterday your favorite part comes from is where...
Yeah, where we actually see the alien queen. Ripley goes in by herself to go get nude out. Gives the queen the ultimatum.
Yeah, essentially. Let us go or I'll burn everything.
Yeah, and then does it anyway.
Yeah, you see the facehugger. Like, the queen pretty much goes like, yeah, cool. She calls her guards off and the guards back off and then the egg opens. And then you just see the Ripley's face of...
Yeah. And then you think it's all good and rosy. And then you have the best part in the whole movie. Queen Alien versus...
Ripley on the power lifter.
Yeah. Awesome.
If you haven't seen that, it's a very, very good fight.
Yeah, it's so cool.
Mm. Little cool fact as well, because it is the 30th year of Aliens. The shoe company Reebok, which is featured in the film a little bit, they actually made the Alien shoes. So, like, the high-top Alien shoes that Ripley wears.
Pretty cool shoes.
I want a pair. They look fucking awesome.
You can't pull them off, but all right.
Mm. Yeah, I enjoyed the movie. This would be probably in my top 5 or 10 action films of all time sort of thing list for me.
It's very iconic.
Mm.
If you haven't seen it, it's something that you got to see anyway.
Yeah. There are
just
things
so that you've seen it.
There are things I wish they followed, like when the family that sort of first finds the facehugger is clearly told by Carter Burke, the sort of the bad guy in the film, to go get the alien egg. I wish you followed them because they essentially go inside the ship, then there's a time lapse and they come out of the ship.
Yeah.
So I would have liked to see that. Or how the alien queen comes to be. Sort of, because we know how the standard alien comes. How do you get a queen?
Yeah.
Is there a queen face hugger?
Don't know. We'll never know.
Yeah. But yeah. Review time.
Reviews. It's time for us to give it a score.
Yes. Out of an alcoholic beverage, Mr. Johnson, what would you give it?
A futuristic alcoholic beverage. I give it an espresso martini in a glass, not a mug.
Oh.
Because sci-fi. Because
sci-fi. All right, I'm going to give it... We've been having a lot of this recently. I'm going to give it PIMS.
Yeah.
But I'm going to give it a more of an alien twist on it.
Mm.
So it's going to have lime soda instead of lemonade or ginger ale. And it's going to have pieces of lime, lemon, and that's it. Yeah. I reckon that tastes awesome.
Sure. So basically, this movie's good.
Yeah.
If you haven't seen it, you need to see it.
Get on it.
It's not the most perfect movie ever, let's be honest. It's not the best dialogue. It's not...
To you.
Well, it's not the best. It's not good dialogue, let's be honest.
No.
It's a corny 80s action movie.
It's great.
But the movie itself is a must-see.
Yes.
Hence why we're designating an entire episode to it.
Yes. We might do some more birthday episodes in the future. Like 1995 had some great movies. We could have reviewed Toy Story or GoldenEye.
Could have. GoldenEye. Awesome.
Mm. Maybe we should do a Bond theme episode.
GoldenEye. But yes, that just about wraps up our retrospective review of Aliens.
Yes, but we're going to move into our segment that, riddle me this segment. If you have a question for us or it's a question really. It's not really anything but a question. Yes. Feel free to send it through. We're going to move on to that segment this week of the Themes Weekly Theme of this week.
A gaggle, a swarm, a flock of freaking Freuds. Riddle me this!
What do you think, Morty?
I don't know, Rick. I mean, these are the questions of the day, you know?
That's right, Morty. These are the questions of the day. You know, sometimes we don't know the answers to some questions.
So this week, Ian.
Yes.
Yet again, we asked our Shakeners to provide us with a question.
Yes.
That they'd like to answer us, and we've
got an interesting response.
We got a pretty interesting one for number two. This one comes in from Jordan. Tell us a story about the result of your most drunken experience. I, meaning Jordan, shat the bed once after drinking for 13 hours. Beat that. Well, I don't want to beat that.
Congratulations, Jordan, you win.
Some Kensington man pads coming your way.
This just in, man pads.
Yes. Drunk story for me. It was I think it was a friend's going away party at drinks at work or something. And I barely remember the night. My fiance had to fill me in.
That's always a good sign.
Yeah.
I don't remember this happening, but
It was a drinking in the city on South Bank, so like you've got the pubs and the restaurants all sort of next door to each other. And I'd been drinking for a couple of hours, got pretty into it, and then found a couch to just sit on. We all were sitting around on a couch, just chilling and talking. And I fell asleep.
In the restaurant?
No, in the bar area. So the bar, it was sort of like inside bar, outside sort of terrace area where South Bank is, where people walk up and down it.
Yeah.
So the outside area. And there were some couches on the outside area. So we went and sat on them and I fell asleep while they kept talking. And then apparently, I don't remember this, but I've just, like, I didn't wake up. My eyes were closed. I've gone to spew, put my head to the other side of the couch and just gone, bleh, and then wiped my mouth and fallen back to sleep on the couch.
Ew.
My fiance told me that the pub or the bar we were sitting on had one of those little tiny glass adjoining walls for a restaurant. And the back of the couch was against that glass wall. And I spewed into a restaurant while there was a couple next to us eating dinner. So I've just gone over the wall and gone, bleh, and then sat back.
I'm sure they really loved that when they were eating their dinner.
Yeah, we walked past it the other day. The bar's closed down.
Really?
The bar's gone.
Wow.
So
well done, dude. You closed a bar down.
I spewed into a restaurant while people were eating. Like, and it was like a crown area, so it was a nice sort of fancy area. And I've just flat out spewed into a restaurant's area and then just fallen back asleep.
Well done. I guess on the upside, you never shit the bed.
Yeah, no.
Good one, Jordan. Good one.
Good one.
I've had a few drunken encounters.
Of a close count?
Yeah.
Of a close kind?
Pretty grossness. Puked black. Hooked up with a lot of people I shouldn't have. Done some things that are regrettable.
But sing us a song, O Piano Man.
One such story. Which one should we go with?
Whichever one you want to.
I don't know which one to go with. I was in Hong Kong a couple of years back now.
This wasn't the recent one, yeah, it's a couple of years.
Yeah, so I was out partying in Honkers, Hong Kong, with one of my mates, and it got real messy. Real messy. Like I don't remember majority of some of it. Slept in the cab on the way back and puked a lot, and ended up sleeping in a bathtub, because my friend looks after me. He looks after me. So, I can't go back to Hong Kong ever again.
there are times I've seen you pretty drunk. I think it was one of our friends' birthdays in his backyard or something like that. And someone was talking to you about dumping their girlfriend and going back with her ex, and you flat out slapped them across the face really hard. You go, "Don't you," and then you just started running.
Yeah, but he deserved that. He's hitting well above his weight. Yeah, I puked black from drinking tequila and
that drinking session we did a couple of weeks ago at the pub.
Yeah, puked then as well.
With the
Who Spiked the Puns guys.
I actually forgot how we got home.
Really?
Yeah, I woke up the next morning after you left, and I've gone to my fiance and go, "So what did you get up to last night?" She's like, "Don't you remember?" I'm like, "No, I what did you get up to?" I was like, "Oh, I just came home and had dinner." I'm like, "Oh, what'd you have for dinner?" She goes, "Don't you remember what you did when you got home?" And I went, "No," she goes, "you watched The Simpsons and ate my microwavable pizza." And I'm like, "Fuck yeah, we did, didn't we?" We started watching Simpsons and ate fucking shitty pizza. I forgot about that.
Yeah, it was good. Good pizza.
And I forgot about, I remember doing the rock bottom on a friend.
I've been drunk a lot. I puke a lot when I get real drunk.
I can't wait for my box party to see how drunk you get.
I christened your brother's bathroom.
Yeah, go on.
On his house, warming.
He just moved into his new apartment.
And I drank an entire Heineken mini keg to myself.
There's $40 Heineken. We bought two of them. One for everyone, one for about three people, and one for Ian. Just
go hard or go home. That's what I was saying.
And he was getting so proud of these pouring skills when he first started. Like, "Look at that pour. That is no head. That is great." And at the end of the night, it's, "Look at that pour. It is all head." It was awful. Your pouring skills at the end of the night were piss poor.
That turns out the keg was running out. It wasn't my skills. It was the keg running out. And I stand by that. But anyway, to summarize, Jordan, you win. You shit the bed. Congratulations. I hope you're proud of yourself.
Achievement unlocked.
I hope you rolled over in that. That's nasty.
Oh, it's a crap.
Anyway, that just about wraps up Aliens Week.
Yes.
As usual, we want to thank everyone who's submitted, including Jordan. Thank you for the poo-poos.
Yes. Episode 17, we got episode 18, but thank you again to all those listening. All the new likers, subscribers, and reviewers. Thank you very much. Thank you to Thomas Commons.
Yes. So next week, we'll be doing our very, very special...
Our probably our last episode of the year, we think.
Yeah. We might come back for a review of Rogue One, but next week will probably be our last one for the year.
Our last proper episode, yeah.
Yeah. And it's going to be with the Who Spiked the Puns guys.
Yep.
A very special quiz episode.
Yes. Do you want to... Let's just leave it at that. Let's not give anything away.
We'll just that tease. Yes. Just a little tease of a lot of quizzing with the Who Spiked the Puns guys.
That's a shot.
Yeah. So, hope you enjoy this week's episode. Yes. I've been Ian Huge Footlong Johnson.
And I've been the Dudi Dutrum, El Duderino.
And I've been a hungover.
Hungover. How are you feeling now?
Slightly better.
Yeah, yeah, we had Maccas and watched the end of Hercules.
Hercules!
Can't remember the rest. No.
Anyway, thanks for listening, guys.
All right, we'll see you next week for a very special episode.
Bye.
Bye.
Wait. 3 measures of Gordon's, 1 of vodka, 1/2 measure of quinoa lily. Shake it over rice, and then add a thin slice of lemon.
Chicken or stirred?
Do I look like I give a damn?